Well, the extreme heat is taking a toll on just about everyone and everything in our area. For the last 2 weeks, we've been showing you grass fires all over the area, and tonight we're taking you to the crop fields. 4029's Joe Ellison is live in Sequoia County. Joe, what has the heat done to the farmland out there?
Well, it's burning up profit and the nutrients. You can tell by this cornfield right here in Sequoia County. Look how it's a little bit toasted. It's supposed to be a little bit green, but if you take a wider look, you can tell a lot of it is really burnt. Now, it may be okay for this area because it's going to be used for feed, but this heat really is causing some problems for farmers, even those out baling hay.
Well, this is a pretty sorry field of soybeans is what it is, and they should be up about this tall.
Keith Jones spends his day working in a soybean field in Sequoia County. Some beans haven't seen a drop of rain since they've been planted. It's the driest conditions Jones says he's seen.
Yeah, I've been here 27 years. And
farmers are starting to worry about yield production as the hot summer days go by well into the hundreds with no rain in sight. The extreme heat can also suck nutrients out of cornfields like this, used for cattle feed. Even with irrigation systems, the heat is starting to scorch farmers' profits.
Once we cut this, there's no moisture. It's not going to grow back for a second cutting.
Usually a farmer can cut a field three times a summer to stock up hay for their livestock's winter feedings.
If the weather continues the way it is and there's no grass, we're going to have to start feeding hay first of August.
For farmer and Arkansas Senator Bruce Holland, the weather is literally burning up profit. Even with a fire extinguisher, a small spark from a bearing on a tractor set a fire tearing through this bonanza field. It took the Forest Service and four fire departments to stop it from spreading, but it still took out quite a bit of profit.
About 34 acres, and which is some hay that we didn't get to bale.
Now, a lot of farmers and, of course, the extension offices in the counties in our areas, they're keeping a close eye on these crops because, of course, that's going to affect us at the grocery stores. If a lot of these crops don't bounce back, we're going to pay a little bit more whenever we go to the grocery store to buy our produce, Angela. So we just really need some rain out here. These farmers are hoping that we get some really soon.
We're going to need to do our rain dances. All right, Joe, thank you. And county extension offices in our area are keeping a close eye on hay production. Many people from Texas have been shipping in hay from Oklahoma.